Unfold Zero is interviewing Angela Kane, the UN High Representative for Disarmament Affairs. Good afternoon, Ms. Kane. Thank you very much for agreeing to be interviewed by Unfold Zero. Firstly, September 26th is the first International Day for the Total Elimination of Nuclear Weapons. What are the aims for this day?
Oh, it's really the first time that it's being celebrated this year in 2014, because it was agreed to by a high-level meeting on nuclear disarmament that was held last year. And the aim is really to focus on what more can we do to actually achieve nuclear disarmament. And I think that's very positive, because it comes in the week that is really the most high-level week of the entire year in the United Nations. And so to celebrate it, or to commemorate it, I should say, because I wish we'd have something to celebrate that would be more concrete, for nuclear disarmament, but to commemorate it and to pay attention to it and to focus on it during this high-level week is extremely meaningful. So I'm very happy that this day was chosen to commemorate nuclear disarmament and to point to the need for nuclear disarmament.
The issue of nuclear weapons was the subject of the very first resolution of the United Nations General Assembly. Is nuclear disarmament still important for the United Nations, or has this issue been eclipsed by other issues of importance for humanity, like climate change, human rights, poverty, proliferation of small arms, depletion of ocean resources?
There are a lot of topics on the UN agenda, as you've just enumerated some of them. There are many more. There are many crises around the world, and that will not stop, meaning that new ones will be added, other ones will be taken down because they have lesser importance. But nuclear disarmament has really been something that Doug Hammarskjöld already called a hardy perennial. And I think that's a very apt word, because basically what it means is, until you actually have achieved nuclear disarmament, it will always be on the agenda of the United Nations. And it will always be an important part of the agenda of the United Nations. I think that all of the meetings that we have, there are numerous meetings going on throughout the year in various fora focused specifically on nuclear disarmament. So until we've actually achieved it, that's only when it will actually disappear from the agenda.
The Conference on Disarmament, the main negotiating body for nuclear disarmament, has been blocked for 18 years. Do you think it's possible to advance multilateral nuclear disarmament negotiations in other forums, like the Non-Proliferation Treaty Review Conferences, or the UN Open-Ended Working Group, or through the UN General Assembly?
I think it's always possible to make progress somewhere. Whatever that forum is, it doesn't really matter. You know, we always talk about the political will not being there. And I think that it's unfortunate that the Conference on Disarmament has been meeting for so many years without concrete achievements. And it's a little bit about the Sisyphus. You push it up a little bit, the rock, and then it sinks down a little bit further. And I hope that there will be a breakthrough. I hope that it will be possible to have concrete achievements, but frankly, I don't see it. I did not see it last year. I didn't see it the year before. I don't see it this year. So in order for concrete achievements to be made, maybe they would have to be stimulated from the outside in another forum and could then be brought to the Conference on Disarmament. That, I think, is a possibility. But on the other hand, let's not forget also that the Conference on Disarmament is a limited body. It only has about a third of the membership of the United Nations in general. So I think it also behooves those countries that are not in the Conference on Disarmament to nudge this process further and nurture it in another forum, and then possibly to bring it to the Conference on Disarmament.
The UN Secretary General has called for negotiations on a nuclear weapons convention or package of agreements as part of his 5-point plan for nuclear disarmament. How do you think such negotiations could happen?
Well, if there's political will, they could start tomorrow. But I am afraid that what is happening is that the idea of a nuclear convention negotiation has not been accepted by the P5. And obviously, they are the ones who would be ultimately concerned and ultimately involved. You cannot negotiate a convention and leave them out of the picture, because then it's not worth the paper it's written on. So unless you can actually engage the P5 to start the process and to start thinking about it, start preparing, to start negotiating it, I don't think that it's actually going to go very far. There is the idea has been pushed very strongly also by the non-aligned movement. They're very much in favor of it. It does come up in resolutions. But again, you cannot do it in isolation. You cannot do it only the non-nuclear powers negotiating it, because then it does not achieve the aim which it is set up for.
Can we learn something from the experience of chemical weapons? So, for example, with the Chemical Weapons Convention, the possessors of chemical weapons first agreed to a prohibition on the use of chemical weapons. And then later, they agreed to the Chemical Weapons Convention, the phased program for elimination. Do you think that this approach could work with nuclear weapons? That the nuclear weapons possessors could agree first on a prohibition of use and then later on the program for elimination?
I think it's very good to think about various ways of addressing it, because I think we're a little bit stuck in a rut. Because we're stuck in a rut because we always look to the NPT, and the NPT does have the pillar, the one pillar of nuclear disarmament, but there is dissatisfaction on the part of the non-nuclear weapon states that they feel nothing has happened that will actually achieve nuclear disarmament, and there doesn't seem to be a timetable, there's not enough transparency, so there are a lot of problems that they see that it isn't moving fast enough. So to bring in other ideas, to sort of maybe take a gradual step, or maybe take a first step, which would then be agreed to by the nuclear weapon states, I think would be very positive. And I think it's good that one can discuss it, one can put it on the table, and one can test the reaction of the nuclear weapon states. But I think it is good to think about this. And if it happened like in the Chemical Weapons Convention is a huge success. There are very few countries near universal, very few countries outside of it. But on the other hand, we're really not talking about a lot of states that have nuclear weapons either. So already you've got a big advance in that sense.
The United Nations provides a range of forums for the resolution of conflicts, for responding to threats to peace, and for implementing international law. How important do you think these forums and mechanisms are for the elimination of nuclear weapons and to build the confidence to make a nuclear weapons-free world possible?
I think that we are working on anything that makes the world safer and that makes it a better place for civilians. We're focusing now on nuclear weapons. Let's not forget the conventional weapon side, which is extremely important and which kills thousands of civilians every day, every week, every month. But on the other hand, I think that the nuclear weapons issue has been handled in very specific fora. For example, the Security Council will not often, they've had a resolution 2 years ago on nuclear weapons, but they will not very often take up this issue. And the question is, of course, would they be willing to take up this issue? Would they be willing to engage a debate? So far, the answer has been no. But I think there could also be more pressure brought upon the Security Council members, and particularly the non-permanent ones, which are non-nuclear, to further this possibility of discussing it in additional fora, which would give more of an interface, let's put it that way, with some of the crises that exist.
Thank you very much, Ms. Kane, for agreeing to the interview with Unfold Zero, and we wish you all the best for your work, and we look forward to supporting you in this endeavour.
Thank you very much. Thank you. Thank you.